is, derives from the Spanish pasar, to walk, and calle, street, to walk down the street. Okay? And there are so many composers who have composed a piece called Pasacalia. I can't even tell you how many there were. Frescobaldi, Bach, Buxtehude, Mendelssohn, Max Reger, Ralph Vaughan Williams, Leo Sowerby, Monteverdi, it just goes on and on and on. Brahms, Haydn, Handel, there's everybody composed a piece called Pasacalia. Well, what you're going to hear now is a Pasacalia based on Handel's writing of it, but a guy by the name of Johan Halvorsen, Norwegian, listened to the Handel one and said, aha, I'm going to adapt this for my own. And he was born in Drammen, Norway. He was an accomplished violinist from a very early age. He became a prominent figure in Norwegian musical life. And it goes on to tell about his education and his life. He was born in 1864 and died in 1935. So relatively recent. So this is the Halvorsen setting of the Handel Pasacalia.
Thank you.
Sebastian Bach's Serenade.
Fatto per la notte di Natale, which is in a
Italian means made for the night of Christmas. And you'll listen to it and you'll go, I don't understand what the Christmas part is. And then you get to the last movement, the pastorale. And the pastorale is either in 6, 8, or 12, and I can't remember. 12, thank you. But it's supposed to sound like you're rocking the cradle. So that'll tell you about the tempo, right? It's supposed to sound like you're rocking the cradle. And that's how it got its name, as the Christmas concertos. It sounds like you're rocking the baby in the cradle on the last movement. So that's how we know it's the last movement, too. So anyway, here, I'm just thrilled that you're doing this whole thing. I really am. And our two soloists are, once again, Darius Kuku and Quentin Duffy, both of whom have played with the Maui Chamber Orchestra. So here is the Concerto Grosso, number 8, opus 6, by Corelli, known as the Christmas Concerto.
Thank you. Thank you.
instrumentation, they don't have accurate records of the instrumentation, but they think the instrumentation was about 13. So when you see these massive productions of 200 in the orchestra and 4,000 in the chorus, it's all wrong. It's all wrong, okay? And when you do it the way that it was intended, the tempos pick up and crisp up, the whole thing becomes a new piece. And he wrote the whole work in 24 days. 24 days. Amazing. Now, I have two copies of the chordal score here. I need someone who was a tenor who sung this before, Bill, and someone who was a soprano who sung it before, and someone who's an alto who sung it before, and the four of us are going to stand up here and we're going to lead the group in singing of the Alleluia chorus. So I need you to come up. I've got the music for you. So if you're an alto who sung it before, get your butt up here, and a soprano, come on. So this is where the